right onto Pennsylvania 45 West Old Turnpike Road.
Russia's little territory has been pulled back from Moscow. So 6 days ago, Kiev decided to take the fight to Russia itself in a different, more direct way. Kiev sent troops pouring into...
Continue on Pennsylvania 45 West for 1.5 miles. This route avoids road closures on Dreisbach Church Road. You are on the fastest route. You should reach your destination by 7.06 a.m.
First, the Kiev military is conducting a cross-border offensive. His forces are reported to have opened up a new 30-kilometer front. President Zelensky thanked the people of Ukraine to us.
Is your point in? Chief Commander Shep, today I received several reports from Commander Chief Sirsky regarding the front lines anxious to push through.
Salem Church Road. Sharp left onto Salem Church Road, then turn right to stay on Salem Church Road. Turn right to stay on Salem Church Road.
Evacuate as well, people being told to leave on the Ukrainian side of the border as well in the Sumy region, from where recent years. Where do those relations stand?
11 minutes, 33 seconds.
If you look at the list of countries that have the most migrants to Australia, it is India and China. And safe to say, in recent years, diplomatic relations between Canberra and Beijing have been extremely strained. And that could be one reason why certainly the Prime Minister, Mr. Albanese, is remaining very tight-lipped on who these other countries might be.
Thanks for filming us in Australia. Listening to the newsroom from the BBC World Service. Still to come, a week since demonstrations led to a new Prime Minister, a question for the people of Bangladesh.
What brings you here? I mean, you have succeeded, your demand has been fulfilled. Why are you still here?
We try to find out. The final day of the Paris Olympics has got underway. It is the 16th day of competition and the last of the 329 gold medal events are taking place ahead of that closing ceremony. Sifan Hassan of the Netherlands has won the women's marathon. She beat Ethiopia's Atfefa in a sprint finish to set a new Olympic record time. Let's listen to the end of that race.
Sifan Hassan, who already has a bronze medal from the 5,000 metres. Sifan Hassan, who won a bronze medal in the 10,000 metres only on Friday night. Now Sifan Hassan on Sunday morning is the Olympic champion in the marathon. It is Tigis Dassefa, the world record holder, who takes the silver medal.
South, South 10th Street.
Thank you.
since 2017, we've been investing more than 1.2 billion in those sport equipment. We have also transformed the transport, the public transport system, and deployed services for the disabled people so that we improve really the level of accessibility. There is also the big legacy, which is going to be ability to swim in the River Seine starting next summer, and this will change the quality of life at a time when we have that climate warming, global warming. So that's a big element too. But I think more importantly, it's a real great demonstration of the power of sports and the power and the capacity, I would say, of France to achieve great things, to really work in a united way with high ambitions to deliver something that the country can be proud of. And that is an invaluable legacy.
As Amélie Oudéa-Castel, the French Minister for Sport, you're listening to the Nation of the Bruxelles. Well, as Israel issues new evacuation orders for more areas of southern Gaza, there's been further international condemnation over the number of civilians killed in an Israeli airstrike on Saturday on a school compound sheltering displaced Palestinians. The latest criticism came from the US presidential candidate, Kamala Harris, as we heard from our correspondent in Israel, Jenny.
Arguably, Israel's greatest ally and, of course, a major supplier of weapons, has expressed its dismay at the strike as that international condemnation mounts. We heard from Vice President Kamala Harris, who said that yet again, too many civilians have been killed. She added that Israel has the right to go after Hamas, but it also bears a special responsibility to avoid civilian casualties. The Israeli military continues to insist that it used precision missiles to target what it claims was a Hamas command center within the school compound. It's published a list of the names of 19 people killed in the strike, which it says were either Hamas or Islamic Jihad operatives. And the big question, of course, as you've been asking all morning, I imagine, is where does this leave any hope of a ceasefire and hostage return deal? Because, of course, the strike came at a time of very heightened tension in the Middle East, with the international community urging both Hamas and Israel to get to the negotiating table and agree upon a ceasefire and hostage return deal. Kamala Harris herself reiterated those demands. But listen to what Hamas had to say in reaction to the strike. They described it as a horrific crime and said that Israel, in effect, had escalated the conflict. So this morning in Gaza, as people continue to mourn their dead, absorb the shock, and of course pray for those injured, the prospect of peace seems very remote indeed.
That was Jenny. It's been a week since the nationwide demonstrations that forced the Prime Minister of Bangladesh, Sheikh Hasina, to flee the country. And now the political upheaval has led to a security vacuum, it seems. There are reports that there are very, very few police on the streets at the moment, and there's growing concern about intercommunal violence breaking out. People, though, are organising nightly neighbourhood watch groups, and they've posted volunteers outside temples to stop looting. Good evening, everyone. This is Bush 1,
one of the busiest junctions in Dhaka, the vast metropolis of more than 10 million people, and many million more if you count the unofficial number of people who live in this city. Now, this country and this city came to a standstill when the government collapsed just a few days ago. But life is coming back slowly, and with it, the infamous traffic of Dhaka City, which is pretty bad on a good day.
conflict whilst upholding coexistence. Stephanie Princess has this report.
Assam, India's northeast, has one of the highest populations of wild elephants of any of India's states. A source of pride, but also of concern. While most interactions between humans and elephants are peaceful, the results when they're not can be catastrophic and even fatal, with an average of 80 elephants and 70 humans killed each year. Until now, Assam's government has recommended installing electric fences to keep elephants away from towns and villages. Now it's stepped up its approach, with a new app giving people a number.
In a quarter mile, turn right onto US 522 South West Market Street.
Element that works in real time, so communities can be alerted to approaching herds. Second is advice on how people can take evasive action. And there's also a logging system for incidents, so villagers can apply for compensation quickly if their property is damaged. The app was designed by a team of conservationists and will initially be given to areas...
At the light, turn right onto US 522 South West Market Street.
...across the northeast.
Stephanie Prentice reporting. Plenty more on all our top stories on our website, bbc.com/news. But from the newsroom for now, that's it. Bye-bye.
This is the BBC World Service, where Mike Lanchin has been hearing about...
Continue on US 522 South for 31 miles.
There could be as many as 11 million illegal immigrants living in the country. 7 million from Latin America.
The reality is that the economy of this...
mile, turn right onto Kishakakia Street. Take the next right onto Kishakakia Street, then turn left onto East Charles Street. At the light, turn left onto East Charles Street. In a quarter mile, merge onto US 22, Business West. In 1,000 feet, turn left onto Pennsylvania 103 South. At the light, turn left onto Pennsylvania 103 South. In a quarter mile, turn right onto Helen Street. You have arrived.